section, we will look at some examples of selected extended reality training applications that have been developed by companies in the simulation industry. This is by no means an exhaustive list, but instead some highlights and notable developments. It is interesting to note that there is participation from both large and small to medium-sized companies as well, and both established companies and startups. CAE is one company that is very well established in the simulation industry, and they've been making progress developing extended reality training applications. One example is the Sprint Virtual Reality Trainer, which is an important element of the CAE Trax Academy training continuum. This is based on commercial off-the-shelf technologies in conjunction with CAE's Medallion Image Generator. The product suite includes a VR headset, haptics for sensory feedback, physical flight controls, including the joystick, throttle, and rudder pedals, in conjunction with a learning management system. The visual system provides a high-fidelity representation of both the cockpit instrumentation and the out-the-window view. The system utilizes a virtual coach and the CAE RISE tools for assessment and evaluation. In another example, the Mission Augmented Virtual Reality Rear Crew Trainer, also known as the MAVRC Trainer, from CAE uses mixed reality to provide an immersive environment for training aircraft rear crew members. It can be used as a standalone trainer or be integrated with a full mission simulator to provide whole crew training of the pilot and rear crew. The mixed reality is delivered through the use of a head-mounted display. The display, which provides a representation of the complete interior of the aircraft, is used in conjunction with a fuselage replica that includes aircraft panels and multifunction displays. The aircraft panels can be simulated for enhanced realism. Through the recent acquisition of L3 Harris Military Training Business, CAE also has in its suite of extended reality products the Blue Boxer Extended Reality Flight Training System, originally developed by Link Simulation and Training. This is a small footprint system that is easily deployable. The system uses operational flight programs, actual or simulated, for increased training fidelity. The system includes CAE's adaptive learning engine, which gives instructors real-time feedback, including biometric data and analysis. CAE also uses augmented reality in other applications, including for classroom training. Kratos Defense and Security Solutions is another company that has been successful in developing mixed reality training systems. The multi-position aircrew virtual environment trainer is a mission rehearsal system that is in use by the U.S. Air Force. The system enables fully immersive, true-to-life simulation of combat scenarios, giving crew members the ability to experience the real world and interact with virtual objects. For example, the helmet-mounted displays and mixed reality technology make it possible for students to see their own hands and also other crew members in the simulation. Students can scan 360 degrees and see the inside of the cabin and out the window. This is made possible by the mixed reality holodeck developed by Kratos. The UH-1 multi-position aircrew virtual environment trainer includes a physical UH-1 helicopter cabin with simulated weapons and mounts, all of which is enclosed in the holodeck. The holodeck system includes an image generator, host, VR headsets, stereoscopic cameras with a dynamic viewpoint, head tracking system, as well as special lighting technology. According to publicly available information from the U.S. Air Force, the training system that is in use at Warren Air Force Base is credited with contributing to an increase in combat mission readiness rates, from 50 to 60% to 80 to 90%. This has also resulted in a decreased requirement for flight hours for the operational units relative to initial mission upgrade training. A startup company called Red 6, which was founded in 2018, has been working on a technology to overcome capability gaps that the founder, who was also an F-22 pilot, saw with existing flight training. Red Air training has always been extremely resource intensive and expensive, but it is also necessary in order for pilots to practice tactics and rehearse missions in a live environment to supplement ground-based training. Red 6 developed the Airborne Tactical Augmented Reality System, or ATARS, which provides adversary forces represented through virtual and constructive elements injected into the cockpit of a live aircraft during training sorties. ATARS builds on existing AR technology and provides the adversaries as constructive elements superimposed in the live environment field of view. Commercial off-the-shelf technology has been employed in the system to the fullest extent possible, taking existing technologies and combining them in new ways. For aspects where existing commercial off-the-shelf technology was not sufficient, such as the system optics, in this case, purpose-built systems have then been developed. The system can be tethered to range infrastructure and LVC architecture, or untethered depending on the training task at hand. There are four primary elements of the ATARS technology. First is a tracking element, which is a highly accurate GPS that tracks the position of the aircraft. The display for ATARS is a purpose-built curved holographic lens with approximately 150-degree field of view. This can attach to any existing helmet. And then there is an artificial intelligence link and a game engine, with the system employing the Unreal Engine from Epic Games. The technology has caught the attention of the U.S. Air Force and was awarded a $70 million Small Business Innovation Research Phase 3 contract in September of this year. This involves the AR technology being integrated into a T-38 trainer aircraft to validate the safety and evaluate it in training scenarios. Vario, a Finnish company which was founded only recently in 2016, has developed a human eye resolution mixed reality solution that is well suited for military training applications. Vario's XR3, VR3, and Aero headsets are said to offer the highest resolution available in a synthetic environment, and the 150-degree field of view is the widest currently available in the industry. The headsets are lightweight and ergonomically designed to eliminate discomfort and simulator sickness after long periods of use. The headsets are compatible with a wide range of 3D software, including some of the prominent ones used for military training applications. These include Epic Games' Unreal Engine, CAE Medallion, MVR Virtual Reality Scene Generator, Prepared by Lockheed Martin, VBS Blue IG by Bohemia Interactive Simulations, and Vital by Flight Safety International. The Vario headsets are being integrated into simulation and training applications. In one example, Bohemia Interactive Simulations integrated Vario's XR3 headset with VBS Blue IG software for the whole Earth visual environment, along with a portable AH-64 reconfigurable virtual collective trainer into an Apache helicopter simulator mobile training solution. In another example, the Gripen EF simulators from Saab will feature Vario's XR3 headsets. Saab found one of the drawbacks to using virtual reality devices for pilot training was that limited resolution prohibited pilots from being able to read text in the virtual environment, which is a necessity to training. Vario's technology was able to eliminate that obstacle.